Jesus. Yes, they give us courage and day. Let us be distracted in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hi everyone, my name is Mel. I prayed last week to see what I would share about, and he said I have to share about God's love for us. This is how I know that God loves us. Please turn to John 3:16. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Amen.
So God showed us how he loves us by sending his Son to die for us.
Amen.
Next, please turn to 1 John 4:19. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved. It means because God had so much mercy, even when we were sinners, he loved us. And then when we realized that he loved us, we started loving him.
Romans 5:6-8. Who here enjoys her study?
For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. For a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some would even dare to die. But God commended his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen. So what does that mean to you, Mel?
It means, say, hardly anyone would die for a righteous person, but then God died for us and we were sinners.
Romans 8:38-39. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
So nothing in the whole world can separate us from God's love, which is in his Son, Jesus.
Amen.
So if you think that no one loves you, God loves you, and I just proved it to you.
That's it. You did a good job, Noah. Thank you, Jesus.